On day one of Queensland's 50-cent fares, tourists were blown away.
It's just really unbelievable that you can get on a train and we're going to surface paradise that distance for 50 cents.
That's amazing.
Oh, much cheaper than Melbourne.
At Brisbane's Central Station,
we thought, oh, we'll just catch the train and instead of paying for parking.
It's very cheap for me.
To surfers paradise.
I don't need to find a car park anywhere.
And the Sunshine Coast. No passenger surge, but plenty of praise.
I'm a pensioner, you know, rely on public transport, so it will help a lot.
Maybe more younger people will use it.
Well, I don't go to Busco, I just jump on.
The Premier and Transport Minister caught the Redcliffe line to work.
Early reports are in and 50 cent fares is a win.
Most of them have worked out to the dollar how much they're saving with 50 cent fares.
Maybe $100?
But still a fair way off securing cheap fares for good. The goal is to exceed pre-COVID levels. That's an increase of more than 13%.
The foregone ticket revenue over the six-month trial is budgeted at $150 million. But as patronage increases, lost revenue will also climb, meaning the true cost won't be known until February.
Stephen Miles says it pales in comparison to the billions spent on building the infrastructure.
It doesn't make much sense to do that and then discourage people from using it by charging them high fares.
We look forward to having a look at the results and dealing with it in a mature fashion.
Commuters reminded, use it or lose it. Jacqueline Robson, 7 News.